Alright guys, it's Sadie, and this is a little tabletop Tesla coil that I got from Sunny Tech. I was working on one also over here, and this wire that they've used on this is probably 36 gauge or 38 gauge. I can't wind that wire that small. I got the, over here is what, I went to the hardware store and got this pipe and then just cut it. One inch PVC, cut it, and then I put the wire on there. I do have some finer gauge wire. Also, looking at their Tesla coil has, you can't really see it, but it has one big swoop of copper down there. And so I have too many rounds up here. And so I was going to use this one, cut this in half, cut maybe a third of that off and put that in there. That high voltage transformer in there will get up to 1400 to 1600 volts and has a spark gap right there. So I'm working on that project. But I get some ideas from this one. Of course, this one's more sophisticated. It's got some surface mount ICs right there, and these really aren't transformers. Those seem to be more like what's on the ZVS's, these inductors, and then it has two transistors right here, right there, and right there. And then it has a neon bulb. This is an 8,000 volt capacitor, 0.1 microfarads. You can see it right there. And I did add an extra of these spark gaps. They're called spark gaps, or like arrestors. It came with two extra ones, and I did try to Google them and find out what voltage they were, but I'm guessing it's pretty high, because when I put mine in, the one I put in was rated 350 volts. It started making, the spark was happening very fast, and the output was very small, so it wasn't building up as high as possible. But I got those 200 volt ones, 300 volt ones, and 350. So those are for other projects, but they're very handy. And, you know, it came with, they're using the same concept here, not an open air spark gap, not a solid state kind of spark gap. But let's see, I'll turn it on and we'll see it. It's easily over an inch long, and here's part of a light, like one of the street lights. This is what's inside of the street lights. I found it broken, but you can see this little resistor on there. I'll turn off the light and do some of these. I can feel it tingling my hand a little bit, and you can touch it because it is high frequency. That's how I get my powers. I was measuring this capacitor with my high voltage probe, and it was getting up to like 1700 volts, but I think it was happening so fast that it wasn't registering the full. It's got to be way more than that, I think. But this is easily an inch long. Got the smell of electricity. The smell of electricity is everywhere. I like that. And this thing can come off. This is just a little metal sphere. You could also put a toroid around that, of course. That's what you see a lot of times. Oh wow, there. Let's see what the spark gap, if this will light up. Oh, ouch. There, that works. Not really lighting up like those other two guys. Some of these now you can put music, like it'll play music through the Tesla coil, and I guess since it's a high frequency, it's just putting the music sound on top of it. I did get a kit for one of those, and it does sound like the spark sounds like a speaker. It turns the spark into a speaker. It's pretty cool. But I will do more investigations with this. It was only $49, which isn't bad, but it came with this little chargeable pack, and it's fun to play with. I have to check the frequency on how fast these transistors are operating at, and to maybe see what frequency the transformer's operating at, or you know, how it's driven. So I will look into that because I have my thing here, but I'm having trouble getting this to work. And this is a frequency counter, a little mini oscilloscope, but I'm having trouble getting it to work properly. I have my oscilloscope kit. I will maybe hook that up to this. I want to see. It's probably operating, you know, over 100 kilohertz. But we'll see.